I'll speak to Wayne from the team. Ms. Bogwell, do you hear what your lawyer said?
Yes, yes, Your Honor.
Off reporting his class, leave on the 2 12 years, am I right? 2 12 years, has to be exposed by the criminal court, so what he says he wants to do is not have any witnesses here at the preliminary hearing. He needs to talk with you about that. And so if you want to give it up, you can do that. That means you want to be witnessed. Do you have any questions about that?
No.
You give up the chance to hear witnesses testify, at least briefly. We didn't have that opportunity in case we're on the criminal court. Have any questions about that?
No.
Raise your right hand. Mr. Reddick, what you just said is the truth, and what anything else you might say is the truth?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yeah, be sure to put that sign.
Stop judging by his act.
And the reset sheet there, Mr. Picture one there, Mr. Let's see what the reset date is. What is it, May?
May 8th.
So if you're right across the top, strike up during the sessions court, put in criminal court, and the appearance time is May 8th. So you have, your next appearance for this case will be May 8th at 9 o'clock in the criminal court of law. Mr. Sproles is appointed only for this court. What's your birthday?
321-2001.
Address?
539 Honey Creek River.
You work anywhere when you're writing, Jay?
Yeah.
Where was that?
Hunter's Chicken Shack.
Good afternoon.
Hunter's Chicken Shack, Your Honor.
Where's that?
In Butler, across Northeast State.
It's a restaurant.
So, are you not able to post a bond right now? I know you need help for another court. So, other than that, do you have any income other than that job?
Mm-hmm.
Raise your right hand. You said information is true. Are you owning any property?
Mm-hmm.
Raise your right hand. You said information is true?
Yes, Your Honor.
Just make sure that you sign your name. That's what Mr. Sproles, being appointed, represents you at this particular level. When you get to criminal court, if you need to have an appointed appointed lawyer, you'll have to ask the criminal court judge about that. Mr. Sproles is appointed only for this court. Have any questions about that? Ms. Bogwell, any questions about that?
No.
Sheriff, we'll give you a piece of paper that asks if the court maker says whatever we just said, make later something in criminal court.
We asked the court to reduce her bond. She's currently unable to make a $25,000 bond. In support of that, Judge, we would show she's been a lifelong resident of Sullivan County. She was working prior to being incarcerated. She does have significant family ties to the community. As far as we know, her mother, all of her immediate family is here in Sullivan County. She has no prior criminal record and no prior failure to appear or other issues with missing court dates. And as I said, she has no prior record that would pose a risk of danger to the community. So, Judge, our belief is that on a class D felony, an appropriate bond for her, especially with no prior convictions, would be approximately $10,000 bond. So we're asking the court to lower her bond to that amount that she may be able to make.
It doesn't matter, she's in jail also.
I understand, Judge, that you know this wouldn't clear the way, but If that juvenile court issue is resolved, we won't be able to talk about it.
Judge, just briefly in response, state has no evidence or any knowledge of any prior criminal history. However, the state would ask the court to consider the nature of this offense by reading of the affidavit of complaint. And based upon reading the affidavit of complaint, the state's position that the probability of conviction in this case would be high. And of course, already
discharged. No, they got to the
correct. Correct. And that the court's already advised regarding the positive sentence of 2 to 12 years. There's an absence of any responsible members of this community that appears today before Your Honor to vouch for her or her reliability. And as far as her home situation, Your Honor, the address that she provided the court is not the address where she was residing at the time, and the place where she was residing at the time of this offense, it's my understanding she would not be able to return there, and she had only been at that residence for a brief period of time, and so based upon that, her, although she does have ties to the community, her residence is in question and is unstable, so the state would ask the court to consider those things and set them on.
If I could just respond to last issue there, the address that she provided is different than the address she lived at before. That's an address of a family member who she has made arrangements with. She
well, notice I didn't ask for the
The address she gave you is one that she would be able to live at if she were to
live at. I think the that's appropriate for the charge is in certain terms. And also considering the fact that there's another court worth of the victim judge. Which time is May? Is it May 8th?
Yes, sir.
May 8th is 9 o'clock. The court will continue at $25,000. And that disposal is only $20,000 for this court.